few weeks ago, I uploaded this video where I played Mendelssohn Violin Concerto. It kind of sucked. So that only leaves me with one logical thing to do, to unsuck myself. I think a few of you missed the point of the last video though and thought that I was roasting some random guy trying to play the piece, which I will admit would have been pretty funny. But there was one comment that really stood out. This absolute legend, Fred. Now Fred, he wrote a lot of great things and was expecting the highest of standards. I realized that Fred was my key to unsucking myself. I am sure of one thing, and that is that I'm not going to let Fred down. So the first thing that Fred said is that I was rather tense while playing. So Lugo told me to go for a walk, and taking walks are actually pretty nice. I would totally recommend for like anyone who plays violin, because it destroys you, it eats you alive. And you know what, I would also recommend doing your push-ups, because I already did my push-ups and now it's your turn to do your push-ups. Do them now. Anyways, it's actually really like nice if you listen to all of the sounds around you. Like I hear trees and birds and a dog.
Next, Google said that I should try journaling about my feelings. So I guess I'll give that a try.
Dear diary, today I tried to play violin. As usual, I ended up sitting in a corner thinking if what I'm doing is actually worth my time. And then went back to practicing. Thank you for letting me share my feelings with you and being able to let my frustrations out. Even though you are a book and don't even know what I'm talking about.
Wow, that's actually crazy. My last method was the ancient technique used by the monks called meditating. Now, I don't know about me, but I don't know how to meditate like a monk. So after looking at the technique, I started meditating like a pro, hoping to have absolute inner peace next time I pick up that violin.
I think I like know what to do now, so I guess let's just try to meditate.
The next thing Fred said is that my rhythm was unequal. And this is a big problem for me, because that means I need to use a thing that all musicians hate. And that something is called a metronome. I mean, like, look at this thing. Doesn't the ticking scare you? But first, I have to wind it up. Okay, time to practice. So I guess I'm just gonna... Oh damn. Okay, so I have this thing and I'm gonna put it on 180. And the next major thing that Fred said was that he felt like I needed more expression in like some parts of the piece. This is really true, because for some parts I look like a freaking zombie and I don't want to look like a zombie. So I have made a plan that's absolutely genius. There is no way that this doesn't work. So how do you have more expression while playing? Well, I'm gonna play the whole thing but with my eyes closed. Yeah, hopefully that'll work. And just to top that off and make sure that my level of expression and emotion while playing was truly up to where it should be,
I watched Kung Fu Panda 1 again and played Uguay Ascends when Uguay just disintegrated and went to the spirit realm or something. It's really the ultimate exercise for making sure that you're expressive enough. Because, I mean, nothing tops off the scene and the soundtrack, of course. Like, look at this man. He hasn't even completed watching the scene and he's already in tears. The final major thing that Fred talked about was intonation and more practice, which is probably my biggest problem. And the only way for a man like me to fix that problem is to practice. So hopefully I'm going to be ready for the concert. Just to like tell you, 2 weeks is not a lot of it's not a lot of time. Of course I'm not done with it yet. I still need to work on it. But the important part is that I can't afford to disappoint Fred. I will do everything I can, Fred. Anyways, 28 push-ups now. No excuses or I'll get you.